MLB The Show's coverage of Major League Baseball is on the air. Coming up, we've got a good matchup in store between the San Francisco Giants and the Philadelphia Phillies. Phillies baseball starts right now. Jared Eichhoff, the right-hander out of Indiana, will be doing the pitching in this one. What do you have for us on him, Benny?
Hey, when you dive into the numbers for this guy, he's a pretty good strikeout pitcher. Just under 9 strikeouts per 9 innings pitched. So I would expect him to punch out quite a few guys in this one here today.
So in now for San Francisco, number 18. And as you can tell easily from the splits, he's really struggled away from their home ballpark. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. In there for strike one. Dan Dero, these Phillies as they begin play here today. 4-2 over their last 6 games, including a win last time out.
Yeah, man, nothing they'd like to do more than to salvage this one, Dero. After this one, they go on the road for a 7-game road trip, so big to get this win here today.
Yeah, last game in front of the home folks before you go out for a week. This is a big one. They're going to get it done.
Should be a picture perfect afternoon for baseball. 78 degrees at first pitch. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Shin high, that's taken for a ball. The 2-1 pitch. Swung on and hammered. No doubt about this one. Watch it fly. Gone to lead off the inning. So it's a solo home run here leading off the ball game. 6th home run on the season for him as the Giants are staked to a 1-0 lead.
Well, this has started off certainly quick. First batter of the game goes deep. Dare I say, ambush tactics?
So that brings up the outfielder, Austin Slater. So look at a fastball in there on the outer half. It's 0-1. It comes in with that average down in the 240s. 4 home runs and 21 driven in. A 1 pitch on its way. Hot shot down the line. And that's through for a hit. He'll get it into second. Not in time. And he's in there with a double.
As a pitcher, you'd love to assert your authority early on in the game, but it hasn't happened so far out here. That's a home run and a double against him now, and we're still in the first. He's going to have to make some adjustments quickly if he's going to turn this around.
Here's the first baseman, Brandon Belt, and he fouls this one off. He'll start this one at 269, and even 20 home runs, 53 RBI. One count. Here's the pitch. Slater leads off second with nobody out. Now a fastball here that'll wisely lay off, and it's 1-2. And set up behind the dish is Clyde Washington, as you see the rest of our umpiring crew there.
You know, Dero, he is a pitcher's best friend, Clyde Washington. Down in the strike zone, he'll definitely call that ball right at the knees.
If he's consistent with it, Dan, which Clyde always is, I'm okay with it.
Even count, 2 balls and 2 strikes. Here now the 2-2.
You can definitely tell with that foul off right there that he's picking up spin on this pitcher's off-speed stuff. Maybe expect a fastball on this next one.
Here now the 2-2. It's taken on the inside corner, strike three.
Well, no preferential treatment there. Sometimes we see great hitters have their calls go their way on close pitches, but not this time. I think that was actually a good take, but on two strikes, anything that close can go either way.
Now the Giants' number four batter, Wilmer Flores. And a great chance here for the Giants to add on in just the first inning.
From the stretch.
Fastball here too low, and it's 1-0. Wide 2-0.
When hitters are able to lay off curveballs and get themselves into good counts because of it, you're in pretty big trouble as a pitcher. A lot of guys rely on their opponents offering at that pitch, even when it's not in a good location to hit.
Late swing on the hitter's count. Still a good count for him now, however, at 2-1.
From the stretch.
Oh, textbook slide in there, and he's back at even 2-2.
He's going to step out of the box, adjust his batting gloves, and pray he gets the exact same pitch as that one. Because if it comes again, we like to refer to that one in the biz as a cement mixer.
Wanted to get the front door curveball on the inside corner there, but it backed up a little and stayed off the corner.
And this one misses here. Close pitch on 3-2, but Clyde Washington rules it ball four.
And with first base open, the last thing he wanted to do was give him something to hit in the heart of the zone. So no harm done. Force out anywhere now.
Now at the plate, Mike Yastrzemski. Four hits in 11 tries in the series so far. He's set and the pitch.
This is exactly the situation you drew up from an offensive standpoint. Good pitcher on the mound, but you got a chance to bury him early in this one.
Runners are at first and second with one away. That ball getting a little deeper now. It's 2-0.
A time to start making some quality pitches. He finds himself in a tough spot behind an account with guys on base.
The 2-0 on the way.
In right now, a pitch has fallen behind an account with a guy up that hits really well with runners in scoring position.
A 3-1 pitch takes a strike for a full count now, 3-2.
One of the most frustrating things for me to watch in this game is guys getting count leverage and not pull the trigger on a fastball middle in. That's why you play, to get in those situations where you can try and do damage. What do you want, the nasty slider?
And he misses again, ball four. That's back-to-back guys now that have reached base via the base on ball. Next to bat for the Giants, number 46. The average just a few ticks shy of 300 for the season. So perhaps a hit or two in this one could put him up over the top.
Guy continues to swing a hot bat. Hit over 300 last month. We'll see if he can keep scorching here in this one. I think this inning could have far-reaching effects in this game. They're really making him work, and unless he dials it in, it's probably going to limit how deep he goes into this game.
Here's the 0-1. Way inside with that one, a pretty easy take there. Bases are loaded with only one out. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off. From the stretch. That's back toward the mound. This will be a tough turn, however. They get the force at the plate. Turn throw is in time. That they do turn two, and it gets him out of the inning. Another look as they go home to first to get out of a tight spot. The three of us are back with more following this. Johnny Cueto gets hand of the ball for the fourth and final game of the series. Dan, any thoughts?
Hey, you can tell by this strikeout-to-walk ratio, 2-1, that this guy is more a pitch-to-contact guy than a strikeout-walk guy.
Gene Segura standing in. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Now here's the pitch. Good slider there, gets a swing and miss. Danny Dero, this Giants team, as they begin play here this afternoon. They were losers last time out, but still in a decent groove as they'd won 4 of 5 prior to that.
Hey, thanks, Matty. This is a big one here, Dero. They've won 2 of the first 3 of this series. This swing game here, you'd like to win 3 out of 4. I know that you're at this point, but boy, a split certainly would not be good for this ball club right now.
Yeah, Dan, to win the first 2 games, all right, you can live with dropping the 3rd game of the set, but you don't want to end this 2-2. You work too hard early to not win this series.
Sometimes it can be difficult for a pitcher. You're facing a guy that's not known to be a big stick in the lineup. Sometimes the toughest thing is to be aggressive and throw strikes.
Sanchez is there. Throw on to first, and one shortstop grounds out to the other, one away. Digging in now for Philadelphia, Jose Peraza. As you check out his righty-lefty splits, no surprise that he hits better against southpaws than he does against right-handers. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Here's the 1-1. And he's a little too high with that one. 2 balls and a strike. Smoked on the ground up the middle. And into center field as he's aboard with a 1-out single.
Nice execution right there, Dan. Kept his front shoulder in. Kept his hands inside the baseball and ripped the base hit up the middle.
If you're a pitcher right there, you can't get discouraged. Sometimes, even when you make a good pitch, the ball is going to find a hole somewhere. That one right up the middle.
Into the box now. Mark Withenshaw. Strike called. Now the throw down. Ball's there, and he is out. Good throw.
Well, so much for that first hit of the game. Tried to press their luck and move him up to second with a steal, but it didn't work out.
Cueto's ready. 0-1 pitch on its way. The drive out toward the gap in left center. He's around first, heading for 2. And he'll post into second here with a 2-out double.
As a hitter, the only fielder better than hitting the bomb is driving one in the gap like that. He hustled out of the box, though he was guaranteed a double. But I think he had thoughts of maybe a triple if the outfielder hadn't gotten back in right away.
Yeah, there really wasn't any question about that one going for extra bases off the bat. Next to dig in will be Bryce Harper. What a season he's having. Entering play, leading the league in 2 of the 3 Triple Crown categories.
Yeah, this guy's got the home run and runs batted in thing figured out with the Triple Crown, but he's not in the top 5 in the batting average. If he wants to win the Triple Crown, so he's going to have to make up a lot of ground.
And he'll try to crowd him there to start the at-bat. It's 1-0. Slider finds the zone for a strike. chased one there as this is bounced to short. Sanchez is up with it, and nothing will come of a two-out double as the inning is over. One left for Philadelphia. They still trail 1-0. Second inning set to go, and coming forward now is the shortstop, Yolmer Sanchez.
Yolmer Duncan.
First pitch on its way.
Oh. Oh, no.
Misses, ball two.
I don't blame him for not coming over the hard to plate. He circled this guy on the lineup card when he got to the yard today. He's been swinging one of the hotter bats in the game.
The 2-1 home. Lifted the other way out to left center. Bruce on the run. He gets there and makes the play for the first out.
Batting it. The right fielder. Joey Ripple.
So one away here with the bases empty, and that'll bring in Joey Rickard. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Well hit to right, but a foul ball. Tried to get him to go after the slider, but it's 1-1. Ball. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Fouled away. The Giants have struck first here. They lead it 1-0 as we play the second. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Withenshaw calls off the left fielder as he takes charge for the second out.
That is not the pitcher, number 47, Giants, Quinto.
So bases are empty here with two gone, and that'll bring up the pitcher, Johnny Cueto. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Wind up and the 0-1.
One ball, one strike.
Bases are empty here with two men out. A ball and two strikes to the Giants pitcher. Right side, but it's going to be a foul ball. Offering looked like a slider that time, but it's 2-2.
Got to take your hat off to the pitcher right here. He's throwing a little pesky at bat at him right here. Could have easily just took three pitches and walked back to the dugout.
Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch.
Three ball.
Well, he really needs to make this guy swing the bat right here. He's not the type of hitter you want to dance around with.
Ground ball sent back up the middle. There's Segura. And the throw just does beat him at the bag, so the side is retired. Giants down in order. Played an inning and a half. It's 1-0. Next to bat will be Reese Hoskins. As they'll have 5, 6, and 7 here to start the home half of the second.
Three.
comes.
That's a breaking ball, but it's laid off and doesn't find the zone. That one's going to find the seats. Strike one. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. And this one runs a little too far in, ball two. And it's two balls and two strikes now. 2-2. It's a swing and a miss. That's strike three.
Really good late bite on that slider right there. The best ones have that late action that just darts at the last minute. They're so tough to get the bat on, and when you've got that good slider going, it's a great strikeout pitch.
Here's Jay Bruce now. As the first pitch here's a bit high, it's ball one. Comes in with an average of 265, 18 homers, and he's driven in 45. Two and oh to count to Jay Bruce. Outside and low, 3-0.
Well, of all the guys in this lineup, he's definitely the guy I'd be cautious with, especially with a one-run lead. No surprise that he's treading lightly right here.
3-0 pitch. One out, nobody on.
Okay.
And it's up to a 3-2 full count now.
Hey, this pitcher better be careful right here. My man at the plate is not trying to push something to the opposite field.
Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact. Swing and a miss, and they come back from a 3-0 count to sit him down on strikes, and there are two gone.
Anytime a pitcher locates a fastball on the inside corner, it's going to be a tough pitch to hit. That one was spot on, and he had no answer for it.
At the plate, Justin Turner. As he'll take a look at a slider here that misses for ball one. First 2 men in the inning have both gone down via the punch out, so we'll see if he can fare any better. That's inside. 2-0. Two out, nobody on. Too tight with that one. 3-0.
No break.
Omar Narvaez would be next. Turner in front at 3-0.
Now that's a really curious pitch selection. 3-0 and turned to the slider. You have to wonder if maybe he's lost the feel for his fastball.
And the count will be full. Struck him out, so he makes quick work of him here. 3 straight strikeouts, and the side is retired. Phillies down in order. They trail this one 1-0.
Back now in Philadelphia, home of the Phillies, who've certainly benefited from some solid pitching all season long. With the lowest team ERA in the league, it's clear they typically post solid outing after solid outing. And one of the members of their coaching staff told me a big part of that has come from their ability to limit the long ball, a category they also lead the league in. He said that forces the opposing lineups to really string together hits in order to score, because is just not something you're going to get off of. Guys, this appears to be a really tough group of pitchers to bear up.
Okay, thank you, Heidi. Pulled toward right center field. Center fielder on the run. He makes the catch. A great effort to get there and record the first out of the inning.
Now back, the center fielder, Austin Slater.
So the base is empty here with one away. And in to hit next, it'll be Austin Slater. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Fastball well outside. Bases are empty, one man out. Center fielder ahead with a 2-0 count. Slater cleverly has the nickname AC. He was an eighth round selection during the 2014 draft.
I know this guy wouldn't go into the category of superstar, but to grind out the career he has being drafted where he was, my hat's off to him.
On deck, the left-handed hitting Brandon Belt. Here it comes, the 3-0. It's looked at for the first strike. One out, nobody on. Now a swing and another fly ball here as things are getting busy out there in Central. Withenshaw is there now and he has it, two gone.
The first baseman, number 9, Brandon Bell.
So bases are empty here with two gone. And standing in now, the left-handed hitting first baseman, Brandon Bell. Infield in the overshift here, now the pitch.
Oh.
Bases are empty here with two men out. Belt in front, two balls and no strikes.
You can see this guy's more focused at the plate right now. In that first AB, he went down on strikes.
Three and oh now.
Now with the bases empty, I think he needs to be careful not to just groove one here just because it's 3-0. He's a guy that could ambush you and lose one over the wall.
Here's the pitch. Toward the second baseman. Scooped up. They'll whip this one first in time, and that ends the inning. Giants are down 1-2-3, but they're up 1-0. So next to the plate for the Phillies, Omar Narvaez. He starts off the inning against the guy who struck out the side last inning. How did they get to him here?
Sure, man, but they want to stay as patient. He's been throwing a lot of strikes. They might want to start swinging a little bit earlier in the count.
First pitch of the at-bat.
That's the ball.
The windup and the 1-0 pitch. Swung on and driven to right, and no doubt about it. And that one is gone! A solo shot here to straightaway right field. Fourth home run for him on the season, and it brings the Phillies back even now with one apiece.
Better to do it with no one on base. It stings, sure, but a solo shot isn't going to be the deciding factor in the game.
Into the box, Jared Eichhoff. This will take a look at a slider here that finds the zone for strike one. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1.
No.
Lifted down the line and left. And this will wind up a foul ball.
Good chance he's not seeing that pitch again. If he does, it's got to be bounced. But I'll tell you, from a pitcher's perspective, that's nothing but a long strike.
On the first, so a good bounce back pitch there as he gets the ground ball for the first out. So with one gun in the inning, we'll take a look at where these guys sit in the standings. And I think they can pretty much start to think about next year, because they are well back in the division list. Stepping in, Gene Segura. One run in and one gun so far in this inning. Here's the first pitch to him. Here's a slider to start things out. Looked at for ball one. Bases are empty, one man out. Line drive snagged on a short hop, and that's the second out.
Oh man, you can't hit a ball any harder than that. I mean, this ball gets on it in a heartbeat. Nice job to stay with it though, and then make the out at first.
And here's Jose Peraza, one for one after a single his first time up. Cueto into his motion. Here it comes.
Oh! One and up.
Two out, nobody on. Ball and a strike. Peraza is unlike many of today's hitters in the sense that he doesn't have a lot of swing and miss in his approach at the plate. More often than not, he gets contact, and I'm sure that makes him a frustrating hitter to face from a pitcher's standpoint.
You know, he takes his chances when he has contact.
And we'll have to leave it there as the play is made here to end the inning. But the Phils have come back to tie it thanks to this solo home run. We played three full, all tied at 1-1. And we're back from Citizens Bank Park in Philadelphia. Let's check in with Heidi Watney.
Thanks, Matt. In between innings, I was able to catch up with the manager of the Giants to discuss his thoughts on the San Francisco lineup so far. And overall, he's really happy with the at-bats they're putting together. Yes, they've only scored one run, but he said they've done a great job of forcing the pitch count up, and he thinks that's going to lead to more offense for them as this game goes on.
Okay, thank you, Heidi. All set for the start of the fourth, and that'll give way to the veteran second baseman, Wilmer Flores.
Wilmer Flores.
Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Swung on and missed that time. It's 0-1.
Hey, this isn't exactly the way you'd like to draw it up. Not throwing a lot of first pitch strikes, but the bottom line is he's getting outs.
Counts even at 1-1 to Wilmer Flores. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. A ball and two strikes now. Little too much bite on the slider that time, taken outside. Here now the 2-2. It's a wave and a miss. He struck him out.
For me, check swings are right there next to bang bang plays at first as the most difficult calls for him to make. Taking a look at show motion, the batter doesn't appear to hold up enough, so I think the call was right.
Here's the pitch. One run, two hits, and no errors on the Giant ledger to this point. That'll be a souvenir, and the count will move to 1-1.
Not surprised he's late on a heater right there. Just saw an off-speed pitch, wanted to stay back a little bit too long.
Line to second, where it's caught there for out number two. So with two gone here in the fourth, let's check out our pitch speed comparison for the two starters. And both of these guys are working right around the same speed, 93 for one, 92 for the other. Stepping in and ready for another shot, number 46. He's 0 for 1 thus far. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Swung on and lifted in the air to left center. Long run for the center fielder. He can't get there in time, and now it hops over the wall for a ground rule double.
Hey, there's a hard hit ball. It's going to be down for extra bases. The ball had some spring on it, and it bounced over the wall, and the ground rule double puts him on second base without having to leg it out.
So now to the plate, Yomer Sanchez. So go after the first pitch and bounce it into foul territory. Ready with the 0-1.
Oh. One ball, one strike.
Both clubs with three hits in the ballgame. Fastball laid off well below the knees. Three balls and a strike to count to the Giants shortstop.
Time to wake up the offense right here. 3-1 count, all in on something over the heart of the plate.
Three and one, here it is. Now a swing and a deep drive to right. And they take the lead, it's gone. A two-run blast to straightaway right field. Eighth home run on the season for him, and it gives the Giants a 3-1 lead.
There's still some game left to be played, but that one swing could end up being a deciding factor in this one.
That'll bring in Joey Rickard.
The right fielder.
Yes, he'll take a look at ball one. So far, 0 for 1 with a flyout. Up top, it's 2-0. Three runs, four hits, and no errors on the Giant ledger to this point. And here's a fastball for a strike, 2-1 now. Look out, a fastball up near his dome, and that'll wake you up a bit.
Well, giving up hits is one thing, but judging by that last pitch, he doesn't have any consistency with his release point right now. He doesn't know where it's going, and he knows it.
The 3-1. Hard on the ground towards short. Segura has it. Throw to first in plenty of time, and the side is retired. Bye-bye, baby. The Giants strike for a pair as you get another look at the two-run dinger. Bottom of the fourth coming up. It's now 3-1 San Francisco. Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth. And at the plate will be the speedy outfielder, Mark Withenshaw.
Hey, we're still in the early stages of this one. They're only down by a couple of runs. But it's really key for this leadoff guy to try to get on and get a big inning started.
Pitcher wants to have a quick inning right here. Capitalize on the momentum his batters have.
The windup and the 0-1. There's a fastball pretty close that time, but ruled a ball, 1-1. swung on and missed. One and two now. Don't know how you lay off that one, but he did, and it's two and two.
The classic back foot slider right there with two strikes. Usually gets a ton of swing and misses. Nice layoff right there. Fight for another pitch.
He's ready with the 2-2 pitch.
Three balls.
Back-to-back sliders in on the hands. He didn't handle it real well at all in the previous pitch, so why not come right back with it again? Better job of laying off that one, though.
And that misses for ball four. The leadoff walk that starts the bottom of the fourth.
Well, the reason power hitters generally draw more walks than other guys is exactly what we saw right there. Pitchers work around them and nibble the corners a lot more so they don't get burned. He made some good pitches, but he just couldn't get him to chase enough out of the zone.
Next will be the cleanup hitter. Bryce Harper comes into this at bat 0 for 1 in the ballgame. Here comes the first pitch. The count to Bryce Harper and a pitch out, nothing doing though, and that's ball one. Three to one is our score here in inning number four. Takes a look at a changeup there, and it's a ball and two strikes now.
Probably better that he let that pitch go anyway. After seeing a lively fastball on the pitch before, it's pretty hard to sit back enough on a well-thrown changeup.
The 1-2. Changeup swung on and missed for the first down.
The great equalizer, the changeup. That was a really good job of getting him to offer that one out of his own. And it was all set up by the fact that he got ahead in the count and forced the hitter to have to protect. That's the name of the game.
And that'll bring up the Sacramento product, Rhys Hoskins. Runners on first with one down. Downstairs, two balls and no strikes.
This is a spot you really don't want to be in with a great hitter like that. You can't just lay one in there, but you also don't want to run the count to 3-0.
2-1 after the foul ball there. From the belt, the pitch.
That's ball three. I got 3-1. Three balls.
Due next is the dangerous Jay Bruce.
Come on, Billy.
Set. Here's the 3-1. Grounded back up the middle. The second for one. Relay to belt. They get two, and that'll end the inning. Phillies go down quietly there, and it remains a 3-1 ball game. All ready to go in the top of the fifth, and that'll bring up the pitcher, Johnny Cueto.
Johnny Cueto.
First pitch of the at bat on its way. Swing and he pops him up. Looks to be playable in foul ground. There to make the catch is Hoskins, and that's the first out of the inning.
Now batting number 18.
So the lineup flips over and digging in, number 18, comes in 1-for-2 with that home run he hit earlier. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Outside target here, and he hits it for strike one. Some action out in the bullpen. Couple of right-handers starting to loosen up. In there, and it's 0-2 now. Three to one our score as we play inning number 5. Toward the gap in right center, this is going to be a base hit, and he may take that big turn at first. And he's able to hustle his way up to second as he'll reach here with a 2-base hit.
Well, he was definitely struggling coming into this one. I think we can say that gold string is officially over. That's his second hit of the game, and it goes for extra bases. We'll see now if this game proves to be a huge turning point for him.
To the plate now, Austin Slater. Can't find the zone there as he lays off the breaking ball. He's 1-for-2 in this one. The 1-0.
That's a tough curveball right there to stay into as a lefty hitter. That ball looks like it's almost going to hit you, and it breaks over the inside half of the plate.
It's the 1-1. A ball and two strikes. He doesn't have a big fastball, but he was able to get that pitch by him.
And that's 100% a result of setting up with the off-speed pitches before it. If you're not a hard thrower, you could still have some success, but you have to learn how to mix speeds and set everything up. That was a nice job right there.
He pops him up toward the left side of the infield. Segura takes charge, and he's got it. Two down.
That's exactly what they wanted out of that pitch up in the zone. They took him up the ladder, and he couldn't get up to it. So that was an easy pop-up. Well-executed pitch there.
Coming to the plate now, Brandon Belt, runner in scoring position with Sugan. First pitch coming, here it is. Looking at his lifetime numbers, Belt carries a batting line a little over the 260 mark. Now the 0-1. Knockout pitch that time, but a good eye. 1-2.
Boy, that was an awfully close pitch right there. I know if I'm on the mound, I want that pitch called a strike. That's one of those that could go either way.
Hit hard to the right, but foul.
And when a guy starts leaving the curveball up, that's a sign he's beginning to tire a little bit out there. He's got to be able to get on top of that pitch, or he's going to start getting hurt.
He's set, and the 1-2 pitch. Oh, he hammers it to deep right field. And, oh, he missed a home run by a matter of feet. It's off the wall. And tack on one more, make it a 4-1 lead.
Hey, D-Ro, I think we've got a case right now. This team, they're just feasting on a pitcher that he's given up some runs. It looks like he's starting to get a little bit tired, leaving some of these pitches up in the zone.
Yeah, and I think there's a fight at the bat rack right now. Guys are licking their chops, knowing he's a little bit tired, going to leave stuff over the middle of the plate. Won't be surprised to see the bullpen get going.
In now, Wilmer Flores.
Yo,
he'll take a breaking ball too low, and it's 1-0.
One ball. Okay.
So look, now the pitch. Count now a ball and a strike.
Lucky he got a piece right there. He was definitely late on that pitch after seeing a previous off-speed pitch.
That's a ball.
And he lays off for a ball, 2-1.
Great game plan so far by this offense. They're not chasing any of those breaking balls out of the zone.
The 2-1 home. On a line, that's a base hit. So now they'll have two men in scoring position following the two-out double.
Hey, there's another base knock right there. Oh, hitting streak now up to 8 games.
Oh, yeah, no doubt about it. 8 games.
Starting to think about it a little bit. You know, you get past that week, you just know you're locked in.
They start talking 8 games, now you're like, oh, I got a nice little hitting streak.
Mike Morin is on now out of the bullpen as he'll make his 70th appearance so far this year. Stepping in now, Mike Yastrzemski, as he will look at a first pitch fastball for ball one. Runners at second and third with two gone. Fouled off. Off again, and now he's in a 1-2 hole. One and two count. Here's the pitch. Line towards center field. Withenshaw is there, and he'll make the catch to retire the side. Giants will have to be content with just the one. Home half of the fifth coming up. It's the Giants 4 and the Phillies 1. Welcome back for the bottom of the fifth. Here's Heidi Watney.
Matt, I talked with Philadelphia's manager during the break about the Phillies' offensive production to this point. And he told me, overall, he's not happy with the at-bats they're putting together. He said they're not doing a very good job of hitting off the fastball today, which he said is a necessity in today's game. Otherwise, he explained, the pitcher never feels uncomfortable and believes he can get anyone out at any time. That hasn't been too far from the truth in this one, guys.
Okay, thank you, Heidi. Into the box now, Jake Bluse. He'll look to bounce back after striking out his last time up.
Yeah, kind of shocked he got blown away with a fastball. You can tell he was late on that one. And we'll see if he tries to cheat to something this AB.
Little chopper back to the mound. And quickly, there's one down to lead off the frame.
Now batting.
Coming to the plate now, Justin Turner. He got called out on strikes his last time through.
Yeah, Batty, and hopefully he got it out of his system, especially now he's got a bear down. He gets the two strikes in this spot, has to put the ball in play.
Slider gets the outside. That's a strike. Set up away with the changeup, but it's 1-1. Now here's the pitch. Changed things up on him, and he got him to swing through it. 1-2 now.
Well, they've really had an answer for keeping him in check in this series. He's offered very little resistance with the bat in his hand so far.
The 1-2. Hot shot on the ground is short. Sanchez is there on to first, and there were two down.
Now that's Omar. Oh, yeah.
to a hot start in this one. Homered his first time around.
Yeah, that last at bat, Danny, he turned that fastball around. He didn't hit it a ton. He didn't hit it a country mile, but hey, listen, a home run is a home run.
Starts him out with a changeup for a strike.
Hey, it's not always about filling up the strike zone all the time every inning. He's pitching well as we're moving into the middle innings, but interestingly, less than 50% of his first pitches have been for strikes.
Fifth inning here in a 4-1 ball game. Swing and a miss as he pulled the string on it. 1-2. It's a swing and a drive hit well out to right field. Backing up for it is Rickard. But he can't get to this one. It's off the wall. And going for it, the right call. He's in at second base with a two-out double.
He's not going to complain, but he was thinking what the rest of us were thinking when that left his bat. Home run number two. Didn't quite have enough, so he has to be content with the double.
Corey Dickerson looked to provide a little two-out thunder off the bench as he'll hit with a runner in second and two away. And a slider tails outside for ball one. This year against right-handed pitching, Dickerson is hitting just over the benchmark 300 plateau. Source of pride for him, I'm sure.
These are the type of hitters that absolutely frustrate a pitching staff and a pitching coach. He's not trying to do a ton of damage, but he's certainly going to put the ball in play and be a pest the entire season.
Cueto pauses. Here's the 1-1.
He's looking pretty passive here, hitting with a chance to drive it a run. Going to have to make something happen with two strikes now.
Working for the punch out and the offering. Strike three called and the inning is over. Danger averted following the two out double. The three of us are back after this message and a word from our local stations. With Morgan Rodriguez takes over to start the sixth inning on the mound.
Number 25, Morgan Rodriguez.
Digging in once again, number 46. 1-for-2 with a double on the ledger so far. First pitch of the at-bat. Taken, and that one catches the bottom part of the strike zone. And one, here it comes. This is swung on and lifted down the left field line, but it'll get back into the crowd as he jumps ahead of him now. 0-2. Breaking ball below the zone. That's ball one.
He didn't look overly fooled right there because a lot of pitchers will go to the breaking stuff. 0-2, but he certainly looked ready for a breaker on that pitch.
Comes on a ball and two strikes. Boy, good cutting action to that pitch as that's the first out of the inning.
Talk about blowing it by a guy. Geez, I mean, that fastball was way behind him when the swing came through the zone. I have to think he was looking for something off speed, and he just couldn't pull the trigger on that fastball.
At the plate now, Yomer Sanchez batting left-handed here as he takes a look at strike one. A hit and two at-bats for him at this point in the ballgame. Here's the 0-1 pitch. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Withenshaw is there. Two gone.
Up next to the Giants, the right fielder, Joey Rickard.
So striding in, Joey Rickard, 0-for-2 from him so far in this one.
Let's go, Phillies!
First delivery to him on the way. The 0-1 on its way. Pitch taken several inches below the zone, in fact. Hit on the ground out for short. Segura fields it cleanly. Throw in time, and the side is retired. Giants down in order, but they lead it 4-1. Now at the plate, Gene Segura, 0-2 for him to this point. He's ready. Here's the first offering.
Oh. One ball. Okay.
The 1-0 home. On the ground to the left side. And a base hit, so the leadoff man is on to begin the inning.
He doubled up on that one, Danny. Back-to-back changeups. Nice job by the batter right there, staying on that pitch. One of the things that this pitcher will do, though, Mark, his changeup is so good, he's not afraid to go back-to-back hits.
Riding in, Jose Peraza. 1-for-2 with a base hit back in the first inning of play. Down, and he's got himself a base hit.
Well, something you don't see very often. You got a guy that can run at first base. Normally you'll see a hitter trying to take a pitch or two, D-Row, to give that guy a chance to steal the bag.
You know, it's funny you say that, Dan, because coming up in those situations, you want to give the guy a chance, but you also realize that that guy wants to give his catcher a chance, so you're probably getting a piece of cheese.
Standing in now, Mark Withenshaw. First pitch to him is a changeup that can't find the zone. It's ball one. It was a walk in his last trip. Two and oh to the Phillies center fielder.
Boy, the Phillies have been looking for some offense all game long. They've yet to find it. Let's hope they can find it pretty soon.
2-0 count. Here it comes. Oh, my, and that's a base hit in the left field. And they quickly get it in here to hold that runner at third base.
Nice piece of hitting right there. Looked like the guy on second. Got to respect it.
They had to freeze there for a second to make sure that line drive gets down, but eventually does get to third base.
Big spot here. Bases loaded. Nobody out. And that'll bring up Bryce Harper. Here's the first pitch to him. Outside, quite a bit off the plate that time. Now some action out in the Giants bullpen as they'll have both the left-hander and the right-hander get loose. The 1-1 home. Drilled on the ground is short. Oh, he has some trouble with it. Throw to first is in time, but meanwhile the runner is in to score. So stepping in, Reese Hoskins. As he'll look to bring home that tying run from second with a base hit into the outfield. Oh. Now set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. Down the first baseline. Hits are even at seven apiece. One ball and one strike for the Phillies first baseman. Pitching so far this season, Bruce carries a batting line a little over the 260 mark. He's set. The 0-1. And the 2-2. Nearly got the inside, but blew the ball.
Some pitchers fall into the trap of getting in on 3-2 because they don't want to walk the guy. But with the base open, it's not the end of the world if you do. You still need to make a quality pitch.
Ready with the payoff pitch. That's lifted the other way out to left. Yastrzemski under it, and he makes the catch for out number three. So it's two runs on three hits, no errors, and a runner left on. Seventh inning coming up. It's the Giants 4 and the Phillies 3. Victor Romano is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number 7.
Number 54, Victor Romano.
Pablo Sandoval is up off the bench. He's helped pinch hit here to start inning number 7. And he'll start the inning with a pitch that misses off the plate. It's ball one. Here's the pitch. Breaking ball well inside and taken for ball three.
And just when you needed a shutdown inning, a leadoff walk was certainly not on the agenda. He needs a bear down right here.
Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. Full count pitch home, and a good take there as they'll have a leadoff man aboard to start the seventh. It's ball four.
That leadoff walk is a great way to start this inning when you're looking to pad the lead. could be the beginning of good things here in this half inning.
So coming to the plate, number 18, is 2-for-3 with a home run and a double. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. Now some action in the Phillies bullpen as a right-hander begins to crank it up out there. We're in the seventh inning now of a 4-3 ball game. Ripped on the ground to first. Hoskins has it. Segura for one. On to first, and they turn the double play.
That's one of the hardest double plays to turn right there because of the difficult throw the first baseman has to make. No problem this time, though, and they get the two outs they were looking for.
Base is empty now after the double play, and that'll bring up the outfielder, Austin Slater. First pitch of the at bat on its way. Now, fastball a bit too low here. It's ball one. Sliced hard on the ground. Oh, and it eats him up a bit. Throw to first will get him easily, and the side is retired. Nothing doing there for San Francisco, and it remains a 4-3 game. Luke Gregerson gets the call from the pen to take over on the mound and start the home seventh.
Luke Gregerson.
Half of the seventh here, and digging in at the plate will be Justin Turner.
This thing's far from over, even though we're moving into the back end of this game. Only down by one. All they need to do is get this leadoff guy, and they're an extra base hit away from tying this thing up. When you've got a guy that throws a good two-seam fastball, you have to be ready for him to try to run it inside and jam you. Good job to lay off that one, but I wouldn't be surprised if we see it again.
Ball and strike. Sent toward first. But an easy play there at first as that becomes the first out in the inning.
Catcher,
stepping in, Omar Narvaez. Was a two-bagger for him in his last at-bat.
Well, he got a good pitch to hit last time up. Looked for it up in the zone and didn't miss it. Those are the pitches you only get. Maybe once an AB, maybe once a game, maybe once a week. So he certainly capitalized on it last night.
One out, nobody on. And he takes a cold strike up and out over the plate, 0-2. Fastball well outside.
Those were two great executed pitches right there away from this batter. He can hurt you in a heartbeat. I don't think anything's going to leak out over the heart of the plate.
The 1-2. Swung on and missed, strike three.
That swing tells me he was really trying to get a pitch out front and rip it down the line, but that wasn't a great pitch to do it on. It's really not the best two-strike approach either.
Scott Kingery will pinch hit here, and he's the potential tying run.
Number four, Scott Kingery.
And it's fouled away. Kingery, a native of Arizona, he was taken in the second round back in the 2015 MLB draft.
Yeah, Matty, they certainly got it right when they drafted this guy. He has turned himself into an absolute superstar. Everybody knows this guy's name, and kids are buying his jerseys.
job of holding up on the low ball there, and it's 1-2. And the pitch. Bases are empty here with two men out. On the ground to third. And that's through for a hit.
The batter, number two, Kershaw.
And that'll bring up Gene Segura. He'll lay off the slider too low, ball one.
Hey, I know the tying runs at first right here, but if the pitcher on the mound executes, keeps the ball in play, I think good things are going to happen.
Now the 1-0. Swing and a soft liner. Strand one. They still trail it here 4-3. Victor Nerens has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth.
Number 20, Hector.
Ready to begin the eighth. And set to go is the veteran first baseman, Brandon Belt.
The first baseman, number 9. Brandon Belt.
And the pitch. On to the eighth now as the first pitch is a fastball that's looked at for ball one. Plays off again and it's 2-0. Side defense aligned perfectly. Throw on to first in time, so the leadoff man is set down to open up inning number 8. Tight game here. 4-3 our score as we take the opportunity to compare the performances turned in by the two starters. So here's the cleanup hitter, Wilmer Flores. His career numbers against Hector Neris. He carries a .308 batting average. From the stretch. Pulled off on the slider to start the at-bat. It's ball one.
Hey, that's a nice take by the batter right there, but that's a non-competitive off-speed pitch. Got to do better to at least entice a swing.
1-1. Well, as demonstrated there, that's a tough pitch to do anything with.
Yeah, good luck. But hey, a high fastball all of a sudden becomes really dangerous for a pitcher if it's not spotted above the zone. A little height difference makes all the difference.
A little behind on that swing, and now he'll try to shorten up maybe and protect the plate. Neris has some of the absolute best strikeout stuff in the game today, at least among bullpen arms. His strikeouts per 9 is a number that's usually through the roof.
This guy was tailor-made, Matty V, to be a relief pitcher. He comes out of the bullpen, guns a-blazing, two pitches that he can strike you out with, and more importantly, he comes out with an attitude, and that attitude is nasty, and he gets a lot of swings and misses.
Another one sent foul. Takes this the other way to right. And that's in for his second hit of the afternoon.
Well, this guy is off to some kind of series. And he's one of the better road hitters in all of baseball.
And some guys just have a knack for lighting it up on the road, getting that good night's sleep, and finding a way to get to the yard early and work on their craft.
So now to the plate, Mike Yastrzemski, as he drives a liner to right center. And that's into the gap and should be extra bases. And they'll have runners at second and third following the one out double. Cutting it close here, but he comes through in the eighth to extend his hitting streak.
Yeah, and he was staring at his last at bat right there, probably his last at bat. Would have been tough to get him another AB in this one, but he's able to get it done.
Hey, better late than never. And I'm sure when he walked into that batter's box right there, he's thinking, this very well could be my last AB of this game. So if I'm going to keep this streak alive, I'm going to have to do it right now.
Looks as though the decision makers in the dugout will give him a free pass to first, so the bases are loaded here on the intentional walk, and the force play is now in order. Wilmer Sanchez will stand in again as we flash you back here to the fourth inning. This was a two-run home run, definitely one of the big blows of the ball game to this point. Delivery to him on the way.
There are a couple of points in every game that could decide winning or losing. This is one of those critical spots. Time to make some great pitches.
4-3 our score here as we play the eighth. Oh, 2-0 now.
Nowhere to put anybody. 2-0 count, not a good spot to be in as a pitcher.
Into the corner, a foul ball on right. The 2-1. On the ground is short. Could this be two? One there. Relay to first in time. And just like that, the side is retired. Just what the doctor ordered. He gets the double play to get him out of the inning. Don't touch that dial or the remote for that matter. More on the show right after this. Now we're going to have a conference at the home plate area, so it would appear that we'll see a double switch here. Nick Vincent is in out of the bullpen now as he'll be inserted into the number six spot following the double switch. Buster Posey is into the ball game as well as he'll slide into the pitcher's spot, hitting ninth now on the double switch. Settling in now, Jose Peraza. He reached on a single last time and later wound up scoring. First pitch coming, here it is. Fastball here as they take a look at ball one. 1-0. Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. The 1-0. Bouncer to the left side. And that's the first down.
Now batting.
Stepping up to the plate, Mark Withenshaw. He singled his last time up. First offering on its way.
I'm absolutely shocked he took that pitch right there. Right in the wheelhouse, low 90s heater. That's one you've got to let go on.
Bases are empty, one man out. Set up away with the changeup, but it's 1-1. Here's the pitch. There's a swing and a drive hit well out to right field. Rickard back to the track as he takes it for route number two. Here's Bryce Harper now. He was a ground out victim last time up. Here's the pitch.
Oh, what a no.
Pitching isn't always about getting everyone out. Sometimes it's about being smart and knowing when to pick your battles. He's been really careful with this hitter so far, and rightfully so.
A set and the 2-0 pitch. Good pitch there down below the zone. Got him to go after it. Swing and a miss, and that ends the inning. Three up, three down for Philadelphia. Score holds at 4-3. David Robertson enters from the 10 to start the ninth inning as he'll try to keep the score right where it is heading to the bottom of the ninth. Set to start the ninth in this one, and digging in is the outfielder, Joey Rickard. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. Pitch on the way. Big swing at the knuckle of Kerr. Gets nothing but air. 0-2 now.
Interested to see what the pitcher goes to now. After getting that late hack on the curveball, does he speed him up with some velocity?
And a swing and a miss. Good pitch there for the first out here in the ninth.
Here's
Buster Posey now. Swinging it well. So far in this series, he's 3-for-9. First pitch of the at bat. Takes this the other way to right. And Buster's going to make his way aboard. He's got a base hit.
Now batting, number 18.
Into the box now, number 18. As the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one. It's been a 2-for-4 effort for him so far in the ballgame. Swing and a miss, and he's in trouble now. 0-2. Robertson, playing here in his age 34 season. He's a veteran of 13 years at the major league level, which really points to the consistency he's shown since he first broke in.
Yeah, Matty, no kidding right there. I'll tell you what, the grind to get to the big leagues is so hard. Guys just want, they just want to spend a month, a day in the big leagues. So to put yourself here for 12 years screams to your ability to adjust and be a great teammate.
A 1-2. Okay. still even at 2-2. As a look, now the pitch. 3-2.
Not a bad time right here to put that runner in motion. 3-2 count. You send the runner, and if it's a bad pitch, it's ball four.
Comes back with a cut fastball for strike three called, and it's two down.
Well, at the plate, he kind of got bailed out on that previous pitch. I think it should have been a strike. Then he goes down looking, and you really can't feel too sorry for him. Not a lot of protecting with two strikes there.
To the plate now, Austin Slater. As he takes a called strike at the knees, it's 0-1. He comes into this appearance in the midst of a 1-for-4 day. Now the 0-1.
So, that's the way.
One run game here in the top of the ninth. It's 1-2. Hoping to send him packing. Pitch on its way. Trying to pick up that outside corner, but this misses, and it's back to even at 2 balls and 2 strikes. Struck him out, so it remains a one-run lead as they head into their final set of swings. One left for San Francisco, but they hold on to a 4-3 lead. Takes the ball now in inning number 9, looking to close the door.
Number 58, Trevor Gott.
All set for the bottom of the ninth. And next to bat will be the first baseman, Reese Hoskins.
Listen, it's not easy coming back off the closers, but this guy hasn't been super dependable so far this season. And he's blown several saves up to this point.
The 1-0. Softly hit here to the left side. And this will be no problem over the third. And there's the first out.
Number 23. Yay. Root.
Sliding into the box, Jake Bruce. It was a flyout for him in his last trip.
Almost, Matty. Almost went deep his last AB. Certainly just missed it. With this guy's big power, he's feeling pretty good at the dish. Good for him to try and get on something and drive it out of the yard this AB.
In there, and it's even at 1. Gott, a former member of the Washington Nationals, who was acquired via trade last year.
Yeah, this guy's fully settled in with this ball club right now. Knows what the manager and coaching staff expect from him. Is not taken aback by anything. He's been through the spring training process and gotten to know everybody in this organization.
Ball taken there. 2-1 now. And he fouls this one off.
Gift to the hitter. He's up there probably thinking of protecting on 2-2, but when you launch a ball that high out of the strike zone, it's obviously easy to take that one.
Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. Gott has tossed over 30 innings so far this season. He has an ERA he'd like to see come down a bit. Starts the day in the high fours. The next 3-2. And that is swung on and missed. West, and things are starting to look bleak here for the home nine. There are two away now.
Yeah, as they say, there's a hole in the swing in that location, so a good job there of exploiting that. That can be real hard for some guys to overcome when teams start figuring out what locations you just can't handle.
Into the box, Justin Turner. As he'll take a look at an off-speed pitch here that misses from ball one. He could really use a knock here, 0 for 3 in the game so far. The 1-0. Lifted down the line and left. And this will wind up a foul ball. Now the 1-1 pitch. Swing and a miss, and they're up against it now as they're down to their final strike of the afternoon.
Offered at that breaking ball below the zone, and that's a tough one to spit on. But the key is recognizing it coming out of the pitcher's hand earlier, making sure that it goes up before it comes down. More likely to be a hanger when that's the case.
Count even at 2-2. Philly down to their last strike. Count remains 2-2. Swung on and hit to center field, and this should do it. And he'll make the catch to end it for the final out. And the Giants have taken the finale here. They win the series 3-1 as the ball game is over.
Hey, it's hard to win games at any point, but to win games on the road, especially in this ballpark, so they are very happy with this win.
A one-run finish, 4-3, the final tally today. San Francisco took the lead in the fourth and held on until the end. Johnny Cueto earns win number 7 on the season. Trevor Gott records the save, his 22nd. So that just about does it for Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew. I'm Matt Baskers, and you've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to theshownation.com.